Jane?
I wish to make a motion to adopt resolution number 3647, which includes the resolution of Baker City, Oregon adopting the annual budget, making appropriations, and imposing and categorizing taxes for the fiscal year 2010-2011. And after a second, if there is one.
I'll second the motion.
City Manager Bowler and I worked all day, and Jeannie also worked very hard today to take the outline that I had presented last night with no changes into a budget resolution, because last night we had a resolution which did not reflect the numbers that I was making the motion or wished to make the motion toward. So we did that, and the resolution in front of the councilors is the resolution that incorporates the recommendations that I was making last night. And to review those recommendations, they are, there are two sheets in front of councilors that were prepared by Jeannie Dexter, and then there's an additional sheet which mirrors the one that I handed out last night in case anybody wants to make comparisons. But you don't need the one I handed out unless you wish to ask questions about it. The actual resolution, the budget, which is for which I've made the motion to adopt, has the following modifications. It adds in $49,772 into the police department, which adds back code enforcement, less a $5,000 reduction in overtime. It leaves $104,971 in community development, effectively reducing it by $53,755. That is the amount of money necessary to terminate the department, including all of the termination costs that are associated with an event like this, and that follows city policy and all vacation times and unemployment and all of those things. This is the number that is attached to a termination of the department. And the contingency is increased by $50,000, which I mentioned last night. This is the money that I was proposing the city set aside to convey to economic development activities at the county or wherever when the intergovernmental agreement is set up and approved by the council. This money is put into contingency so that it is available to the city manager and the council for appropriation as unanticipated if and when we get that IGA from the county and they request the funds. So those are the only changes. This leaves us with an unappropriated ending fund balance of $722,832. If you add in the contingency of $160,000, you have cash carryover available to get us to November of $882,832. And that is the sum total of the changes made to the budget that was adopted, and they are reflected in the resolution that I put up for the motion.